Who put the number on the arm?
A Jewish guy.
Mm-hmm. And what does the triangle stand for?
Every Jew is a political prisoner.
And that's
the sign.
A political prisoner. How long did you stay in that barrack?
I don't know, 6 months, 7 months.
Did you work there?
Yeah.
What was your work?
Well, in the beginning, they put out to clean the areas, digging for people that coming up from the crematorium, holes, you know.
Digging holes to bury them?
To bury them.
As bodies or?
As bodies. Yeah. And bodies. Then later on you get a little known, the guy that managed and the group that you work. So you get, and then I worked cleaning a little, over there, they made bricks too, bricks. So I worked there a little bit, cleaning, bringing sand, doing this, what everybody had to work. But later on, I got, the first time, I got closer to the crematoriums. And the crematoriums, the guys that they work in, nobody could talk to them. Because this was an isolated area.
Yeah. What did the guys do?
The other guys, the guys that they shoveled in the people?
Yeah.
Oh, this is what they do. They put them on this sledge.
Uh-huh. And they were taking the bodies out? Out of the crematorium?
The crematorium, they were burned there.
I see, yeah.
Where
were they taking the bodies from?
The bodies?
Yeah.
Was a mountain 2 stories high with dead people.
And they were taking bodies into the crematorium.
If they didn't die, they poisoned them. To die.
And what
they
did
you have
to do?
They put them in the gas chamber. Yeah. They had the gas chamber was so full they couldn't make it. So they poisoned people by drinking something.
And then they burned them.
Burned them.
And
they couldn't burn them that much. You know what they had before when I left Auschwitz? I think they had 3 stories high a mountain of people.
Mm-hmm. And what was your job?
So, you wanted to go to work because you knew if you stay in the barrack or you're not going, you're gone. They used to pick up every day people they needed to burn. You better go to work and better not being sick. Sick people used to go till he couldn't walk anymore.
So you went to work?
Yeah.
And what was your job?
So what happened is they took me and other people to clean around the gas chamber over there, not to have signs that people get uprising before to see what's happening. But the end of the buildings, you know, no matter what, always was filthy dirt from the people, they're springing, they're screaming, and they're throwing. They see they're going to die. So this was.
So you cleaned it. With what did you clean?
Okay, you had those the wagons on 2 wheels. With 1 wheel, you lift it up and all thing falls out. You know. So we used to be close to this. We have the ashes there out.
Ashes of people.
Ashes of people, everything. Used to fill up ashes. They used to throw out. If I'm not, they used to. This was hidden, but they used to have. I believe. They used to have their people, farmers, coming in the back, and was a ditch there, lower down. Over there was ashes galore. They didn't know where to put it. They tried to dig holes to dig it, to cover this, but they used it for farms.
As fertilizer.
Fertilizer.
But when you had the wagon with the ashes, where did you take it?
Say,
to?
In a hole, in a ditch. All the dirt around it.
Did you know what you were doing?
Sure.
Who was with you when you were doing it? How many of you were in?
Oh, quite a few people.
And how long did you do this?
I don't know, a month and a half.
And then?
I went away.
You could choose to do something else, or?
No, I went away already. I went away to the other camps.
I see. You were transferred.
Transferred to Dachau.
Did you offer to be transferred, or did they simply took you?
No. They each time when you stood at the in accounting, they count
at the tzelafel
every morning. They count every morning. Everybody is at work, the people that work in, that are there. So they used to sometime every week or every 2 weeks asking for professionals. Who's a shoemaker, who's a barber, who's a everything, you know. So they came up the tone dye maker. So I lift up a hand and I stood on my feet. I forgot. The head doesn't work. It's gonna be in it.
So I
stood up here, you know, automatically without thinking, lifting up the hand. But it's a little different. This is a photographer.
And
so, you know, I'm smiling with tears. So anyway, so I lifted up and I stood on my toes to see that I'm a big man. You know, I'm not a little boy. So everybody, you out, 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 out. And I went to Dachau.